Good evening and welcome to Birdland Theater. Please welcome to the stage, Bill Hawkins.
can't believe this is the most out-of-body surreal experience I've never done. Yeah. Anything like this before. And I don't think I understood. This is crazy. But we got a heck of a show for you tonight. What do you say? A little sheet of Arabic? Count us off.
Thank you.
room. Let's start with Mr. Jonathan Aarons on trombone. Mr. James
Cronin.
Cronin on trombone. Okay, we have two guys doubling on alto and tenor sax and clarinets. We have Jeff Burke, ladies and gentlemen. And we have on alto sax and clarinet, Mr. Ben Goldernoven. My freaking boys. My freaking boys. And they happen to be single. Okay? So, listen, they are the nastiest cats. I mean, period, obviously. But after the show, they're gonna be over there. You're single. Sydney, Hillary, you're single. Just talk to them. Just talk to them. They're the greatest guys in there. They're swift. They swing their nuts off. Okay. Okay, over on drums, we have Mr. Rob Garcia. Okay, we have mi hermano, Victor Marino. And over here on piano, we have the Hungarian barbarian, the best of Budapest. And the whole reason we're here tonight, actually, Balint is the arranger, the orchestrator, the band leader, the musical director, and one of my best friends in the entire world and creative partner, Balint Varga. Opened the Hawkins Field Performing Arts in 1988 when I was 3 years old. She still got that sucker. A boy is a beast. But we made it through the pandemic, and I was just a kid singing and dancing growing up at the studio. I started doing theater in Sacramento. You'll probably remember me as Kurt in Sound Music in 1996. I went to the Boston Conservatory, and then I moved here, and the rest is history. That's all I can tell you. River, stay away from my door. Okay, ten of those. A one, a two, a one, two, three.
Just got me a cabin. You
introduce my first guest. Woo! Have them all lined up in the dugout over here. Pop up one by one. They're all stupid talented and inspire the heck out of me. Okay, this first one, we only met a couple months ago. It was in Ripley Greer Studios, and I was going in to warm up my feet for an audition, and she was squatting. She was in the rooms, passed her a lot of time. And I was like, excuse me, who are you? And I said, I'm just shuffling, I'm just trying to warm up my feet, you wanna go? So we just, we danced for about 20 minutes, we traded, and we became pals, and she is a little freaking triple threat. She has her game face on, she's going hard for Rockettes, she's 22 years old. She just graduated from Oklahoma City University in 2021, and she's got a game face on. She lives at Broadway Dance Center and Steps. She's got acting teachers. She does Don't Tell Mama showcases. And get ready for Mary Donnelly. We got it. Matt Baker. Started falling deep, deep into bromance just in these last couple months. I was over at his house a couple days ago, and Oscar Peterson's Hymn to Freedom is one of my all-time favorite pieces of music. It is my heart, it is my soul. And as soon as I started playing it, he said, "Oh, I know that Hymn to Freedom," which is not very well known. And then I said, he jumped on it and started soloing like ridiculous. And I was like, "Buddy, wait. You have to play this at my show." He's Australian, and he's an unbelievable jazz pianist. Ready to go?
Okay, well,
Next up, I have a very special guest as well. As I said, my mom is going to the Hawkins School of Performing Arts. You're my guest, Mom. You ready to perform? These art forms are so unbelievably important to me. I mean, I'm passionate, but I kind of live and breathe this stuff. I'm pretty friggin' obsessed. And I care, damn it. I care about the history. I care about those who freaking made this stuff up and passed it down. And most top answers, the history is very near and dear to us. I could talk to you all night about that. But my whole life, I've been the sponge. I've been the hungry one, like, give me more, give me more, give me more. But, you know, I'm becoming the elder statesman now. I'm 37. These things hurt more and more every year. But passing down these art forms to people who truly love them too and are crazy enough to, like, be all weird and put in these stupid practice hours, because that's what it takes. It's so inspiring to me to see somebody that's that dedicated as well. And I have somebody here tonight that is, I mean, I've trained some beasts in my life. I've trained some freaking killers, but this one is hands down the number one best tap dancer. I can't take all the credit. She's from my mom's dance studio, but when you're this passionate, you go to other places. So I can't say I'm her only teacher. But I've had a little something to do with it, dang it. her name's Alicia Niwa. You ready?
Give me a man.
because you can solo, you can count, and we vibe out the same roles as y'all. And that was one of the coolest things when I started getting good and being able to improvise and solo, is I was like, as soon as there was one jazz drummer, it was a random party, and he was like, man, yeah, you're one of us. Like, you respect it. I was like, dude, a jazz drummer respects what I do. This is it. So Alicia is not only can do any choreography, I throw at her, but she's also, she speaks the language. You want to go a little cutting contest? Let's go.
Yeah.
It freaking hurt. Thank you so much for saying. Friend named Mia Gentile. Mia is, I'm not a spiritual person at all. But when I'm with Mia, I feel effervescent and whimsical, and she brings out, Mia brings out the absolute best in me. She's just an artist in the most truest sense of the word. We get into the deepest of talks. I hadn't seen her in 3 years, and then we met up in Central Park, and we just went deep into the universe and consciousness and love and life. And she was in Kinky Boots for 4 years. She's a freaking unbelievable jazz singer, and I love her from the bottom of my heart. Ladies and gentlemen, Mia Gentile.
Bye.
entire world. I'm at Max in year 2003, doing Sacramento Music Circus. He was playing Joseph, and I was playing the camel's butt. I was a little higher, but damn it, I was on the show. And I'm at Max. Especially just moving to New York and just having a guiding person to see me through all the freaking craziness of the business, and a person to just a role model that I'm like, oh, that's how you do it. That's how you prepare. That's how you train. I'm so unbelievably grateful for Max, and I'd be lost without Max. Max has done a couple shows in the city. I saw him play. He created the role of Magaldi in the revival of Evita. Best known for his Tony Award nomination for the role of Henri in American in Paris. I mean, it is my best friend, so of course he's gonna do this, but like, I'm so happy. Here we go. Max Von Essen, ladies and gentlemen.
Very, very close friends, really, really fast. I mean, within like weeks, I was like, he's like the brother I never had, which is saying a lot because I had a brother. And I love him. This is the tune that I got to sing 8 times a week at the Palace Theater in American Paris.
Shows. I've known who she was for a long time And like, we were in an audition together and we got paired up. And I was like, it was one of those talent things, like, oh my gosh, like, freaking Dancing with the Wolves crowd. This is crazy. I've just been a fan of it. And she puts up amazing videos that are stunning. And one day I was like, hey, do you wanna, can we do a duet together? Can we just like recreate some Fred Astaire choreography? And she said yes. And you wanna do a little Bounce on the Blows?
Yeah.
And Eloise Pratt will be there. This ridiculous arrangement for these dudes. During the pandemic, I would say, okay, well, what instruments do we want? And then Blunt would write out the part, send it to Jeff and a bunch of other musicians, and Jeff would be at home playing the notes, send it back to Blunt, and Blunt would mix them in. And how many instruments were on Frosty? Blunt mixed 20 instruments together that were recorded separately. So, when this possibility came clear to me, I was like, wait, hold on. This is kind of lethal. I can make any dance arrangement I want. I can do anything. Let's put a four count here. Let's do this, let's do that. Boom, and Blunt does it. Anyway, he's also the form to my themes, and he's the sanity to my madness, and he's the get it done to my effing off. So, this is Blunt. When we were at Broadway Dreams, we did this, I did a tap number Smooth Criminal. And this is when we first broke down. We're like, oh shoot, all right, let's go to home, we'll do this, yeah, yeah. Anyway, I'm stop talking. But we're gonna do this. Let's go.
Thank you.
bro, you have to freaking dance. But despite all the videos I've watched, I've never seen the foot thing in my life.
Rhythm is my business, rhythm is what I sell.
Rhythm is my business sure is swell. If you feel blue, rhythm we need. If you got rhythm, you're sure to succeed. Rhythm is my business, rhythm is what I sell. Rhythm is my business, rhythm is what I sell. Rhythm is my business sure is swell. If you feel blue, rhythm we need. If you got rhythm, you're sure to succeed. Rhythm is my business, rhythm is what I sell. Style piano player in the house that would like to come up and take St. James Infirmary. If not, that's totally fine. Matt's got it. Does anybody want to hop up and take St. James? Anybody feel like it? No? We don't need to. You feel like it? Oh my God. sing?
No, I'm going to just play for you.
Okay. Yeah. I'm not even doing anything.
What key is it?
D minor.
D minor?
Is this a jam? Or just go off? Oh my, thank you for doing this. I love you so much.
Stop talking.
Jr., and when I was doing a production of The Sting, I was ensemble, it was a paper mill theater, and I could tell so many freaking stories, but we became bros. He freaking liked me. And, I don't know where to start. I met him in February of 2018, and then in June of 2018, I was on a tour bus with him, going up from Florida all the way up to Maine, and it was the most surreal thing. He has changed my life in the most unbelievable ways. Kids, when you have dreams, you pursue and you do what you love, and you do what you love, but sometimes dreams, like, come out of freaking nowhere. And you meet somebody that changed your freaking life, and it's, oh, thank you for doing that, man. Thank you for making this magical night. That's it! I love you!
Hawkins Day. Ladies and gentlemen,